Hello and welcome to week 2 of Magic the Vlog. I'm Max.
And I'm Jake.
And we're back with some more magic action.
Now it's time for your favorite segment of Magic the Vlog, Song of the Week.
Yo, what up, what up? Jake here with the Song of the Week for this week, week 2. This song goes out to all my homies. This is DMX. Get at me, dog.
Yeah, I'm right here, dog.
Where my dogs at?
We right here, dog.
Where my dogs at? What must I go through to show you shit is real? And I ain't really never gave a fuck how niggas feel. Rob and I steal, not cause I want to, cause I have to. And don't make me show you with the Mac.
Come on,
if you don't know by now, then you slip. I'm on some bullshit that's got me jacking niggas flipping. Let my man and them stay pretty, but I'ma stay shitty. Cruddy, it's all for the money.
Well, today we're looking at my red green birthing pod. As a matter of fact, last week this deck went 4-0 at FNM. And I ended up winning about, give or take, 20 or so packs because I got first place. But play a little lands, you know, the dual lands. This is just red-green birthing pod. And then for my one drops in a birthing pod deck, you got to play four birds, four land war, just to play any mana fixing. And then from there, I looked to birthing pod them into, if I'm playing against control matchup, I go right into the Mirror Superion because I'm not spending creature mana so I can whip him out from a Birds of Paradise. But if I need some more lands, I'll bring out the Sylvan Ranger. And then my 3 drop, I'll bring out the Mammoth Vandal because everyone's playing artifacts. So it's just really key to be able to destroy those artifacts before they get too intimidating for this deck. And then from there, I can turn the Mammoth Vandal. Well, I also have Deceiver Exarch in there too because he wins me games. You guys are familiar with Deceiver Exarch? I recall one specific scenario in my last FNM where I was playing against Control and he happened to have out a Grave Titan. So I flashed in the Deceiver Exarch, tapping down the Grave Titan, swinging with two Mirror Superions, winning the game. And then from there I like to turn the Deceiver Exarch into a Phyrexian Obliterator. People get mad at me because I play Obliterator in here, seeing as I'm never going to be able to play him if I do draw into him. But he annihilates it in my meta. And he would just do, like, the one game I got him out, I just won, and I didn't draw into him all night. And then from there, the other 4 mana costing, I've got some Slalom Simulacron. He's needed in every deck nowadays. He's so good. And he has an Enter the Battlefield and an Exit the Battlefield effect. Both are very key for Birthing Pod, so that when you have a creature enter and when he exits, he gets me something. And then I have this Baloth in here so that I can gain more life back when I'm playing against the aggro decks in my meta. From there, I've got one of these guys, and he's just very awesome, giving me hasty Inferno Titans. That's just wins the game. From there, it's just game over. And I happen to play another red-green birthing pod deck, almost the exact same as this build, only he did not play Arc Trails, and I ended up beating him because I played Arc Trail, because I was able to ping two of his birds on turn 2, and that's what won me the matchup. But this is just a little glimpse of my red-green birthing pod. If you have any suggestions for your red-green birthing pod or for this red-green birthing pod, go ahead and post a comment on this video. Now we return back to one of our more classic segments here at Magic the Vlog, the tips and tricks.
Our first tip and trick for you today is a way of dealing with an acidic slime from your opponent. You can kill this acidic slime with any removal spell, such as Lightning Bolt or Doomblade. After it's in the graveyard, cast Gruesome Encore. You'll be able to bring your opponent's acidic slime into the battlefield under your control and destroy one of their artifacts, enchantments, or lands. Payback. Our second tip and trick for you today is Grind Clock.
Think about it. This week at Magic the Vlog, we would like to have a little tutorial for you guys about shuffling your deck.
For our shuffling tutorial, we'll start out with the basics. I like to call this the standard shuffle. You separate your deck in half, and then interlace the top half with the bottom half. You'll end up randomizing your deck in a pretty good way. And you can do this about 7 times is how much I normally do it. And you'll end up with the deck that's shuffled very well. Another technique of shuffling is called pile shuffling. This involves dealing your deck out into piles, hence the name pile shuffling.
Ah.
You can do however many piles you want, 5, 7, you could do 9, you could do 2. There's a lot of different piles. And a variation on pile shuffling is the 5-card pile. where you separate your deck, you deal out 3 cards in one hand, keep 2 here, and dump them into 5 piles. If you can get good at it, it's a faster way of pile shuffling your deck into 5 piles. I'm pretty good.
If you're an advanced shuffler like me, and you used to watch the show Yu-Gi-Oh!, you may have a passion for the Yu-Gi-Oh! Shuffle. Notice the technique. This is how they do it in Yu-Gi-Oh! You cut the deck, and then you just shuffle it. It's very simple, and if once you get fast hands, it's a very effective way to shuffle your deck.
Thank you for tuning in this week to Magic the Vlog. If you have any questions or comments for us, you can leave them as comments on the video or send us video responses. Be sure to subscribe, and until next time, remember, your DCI rating is all that matters.
Thank you.